It's 6-0 Swampscott. We got a dog on the field for the opening kickoff of the second half, and things are about to get interesting here. On first down, quick pitch to Billy Conigliaro. He's around the left side. There's a big block by Gary Earle. Conigliaro.
People with him.
Look at the posse he's got. He's got Tony Blood, Maselbas, Boyce, and Bobby Frizzell, number 30, looking to hit somebody, and Conigliaro's gone for a long touchdown, 61 yards.
What an escort, all. They had three blockers go in the end zone with him.
All right, Swampscott goes for two. And the pass is complete to Maselbas. So Big Bull picks up 8 points, a touchdown, the two-point conversion. And Swampscott leads it 14-0. And here we go in the ensuing kickoff for Marblehead.
Maselbas has such great hands. Anything near him, he's going to get.
All right, some great blocking here by Marblehead. And who we get here, Ormiston?
John Ormiston. Yeah, look at, he's got an escort with him also. Because that's a great run back, Bart. And it's supposed to pick up Marblehead's spirits a little bit here.
All right, so Marblehead scores. They go for two. Great coverage by Tony Blood. Incomplete. So it's Swampscott 14, Marblehead 6. We're early in the third quarter. Marblehead tries an onside kick, but the Big Blue with good hands up there and heads-up football has the ball on their own 47-yard line. And again, going wide here. Looks like something you might have done at halftime. Bobby Frizzell, number 30.
Yep. Bobby, still a hard-running fullback. And a good linebacker, a real good football player. There goes Conigliaro around the left end. He's getting good yardage now. We found something, a weakness in this Marblehead defense.
Conigliaro around to the right side. Gets a great block. Look out.
He's got a good blocking down here.
Number 29 is Tommy Boyce.
Great block, touchdown block. And Billy Speed takes him into the end zone.
Second long touchdown run of the day for Conigliaro. Mickey DiPaolo in at fullback on the play action. Great flick by Peter Cohen to a wide-open Tony Blood, and the two-point conversion is good. So now Swampscott leads 22-6, and we're still in the third quarter.
They just can't stop Conigliaro on his long runs, and he ends up with 151 yards for the day.
Marblehead again with another great kickoff return. The one previous was returned for a touchdown. This one comes down inside the Big Blue's 30-yard line. So Marblehead knocking on the door. It's Thanksgiving Day. Marblehead 4-4 in the season, looking for their fifth win. Marblehead
on that tackle, the great
number 82.
Yeah,
all right, the Big Blue in, tackled by Brian Bates. A little help from Dean Anderson, number 60. Pressure coming in from Gopinski on one side, Mickey DiPaolo on the other, and great coverage in the secondary by Conigliaro. So Swampscott takes over and downs on their own 22-yard line. Conigliaro getting something. And right here, nothing doing here. The Marblehead defense not giving up. Third down play. Here comes Peter Cohen looking downfield, and a great catch at midfield going up and getting it. Number 22 is Mike Maselbas.
He's just outstanding player.
Bobby Frizzell with a whole bunch of red jerseys around him, and Bobby gets something out of nothing there. That should have been about a six-yard loss, and Bobby picks up about 5 yards. All right, quick pitch outside here to Conigliaro. He cuts back, getting some great blocking. Look at him moving, and he takes it down to the 35-yard line. Good field position for Swampscott again. Bobby Frizzell inside, nothing doing here. Marblehead, tough, tough team inside.
Billy Conigliaro is having a great day to close out his career down here.
Pass complete from Cohen to Maselbas inside the 20-yard line now. So the Big Blue threatening. Bobby Frizzell trying to pound away. Swampscott having trouble running the ball inside. But at this point, it looks like the offensive line is starting to take over.
Yeah, absolutely. I think Marblehead's getting tired in there, and we're wearing them down. And
up front for the Big Blue, Gary Earle, Larry Mangini, Paige Cullen, Dean Anderson, Phil Gopinski, and that's your offensive line.
Pass by Peter Cohen to Tony Blood is a little bit long, so we've gone three quarters. Swampscott leads 22-6. The Big Blue jumps offside, so we'll do it again from 5 yards out. Cohen on first down, rolling out, looking for somebody, and just relentless pressure from the Magicians. And that pass is dropped, and Marblehead takes over on downs. It looks like there's going to be a flea flicker there for a second.
It looked like it, but their defense is really good. There's a good tackle coming up there by Tony Blood.
That was Stephen DiPietro making a tackle there. Marblehead going wide, and Billy Conigliaro, number 44, with a great tackle for a loss.
Head on, right on the numbers. He had him right on the numbers, helmet right on the numbers, taking him down. Big play.
All right, there it is. Dean Anderson on the old tip drill. You're running practice day after day after day, and the tip drill works. Dean Anderson takes it down to about the 30-yard line, and the Big Blue goes to work for a loss on first down. Cohen on second down for that little dump pass over the middle, and that's to Phil Gopinski, who was came in at tight end on that play right there. Everyone's scrambling for the ball. They're calling it a completion, and they're giving the ball to the Big Blue at the 20-yard line. Here comes Frizzell now trying the left side, nothing doing.
You know, speaking of Gopinski, Maselbas, Conigliaro, Mangini, they're all members of a Northeast Conference baseball team that went undefeated this last year.
All right, Cohen attempting a pass to Mike Maselbas, and that's wide. So that brings on Mickey DiPaolo, number 77. Mickey will be punting again today. Mickey's going to have to soak that leg in ice after the game. He's getting a workout.
I know it, he is. But he can do it. He's a strong guy, and a good football player, Mickey is.
All right, good coverage by the Big Blue punt team there. Marblehead taking over on down. Stephen DiPietro, number 37, is in at cornerback now for the Big Blue. Number 72, Sandy Suter is in there. Marblehead turned the ball over to the Big Blue, and Peter Cohen is sacked for one of the few times on the day back at the 35-yard line. Cohen under pressure again, and this time Cohen gets outside. The important thing is don't take the sack. Get the ball away even if it's incomplete. So Swampscott again has the ball on their own. The Marblehead 37-yard line. Quick pitch to Conigliaro on the left side. Conigliaro gets a pretty good block there from Gary Earle. And Big Blue contains possession. Play action pass. Cohen is back to pass. He's looking. He's in trouble here, and he is sacked for the second time back at the 42-yard line, and Marblehead will take over on downs.
We had great quarterbacks at that year. We had three outstanding quarterbacks, and Peter Cohen, who went on to Tufts and broke all the passing records at Tufts, Bobby Hopkins, who went on to UNH, played quarterback for UNH, and Ken Kinsey, and we had... They all had great arms.
All right, Big Blue recovers a Marblehead fumble, so they'll take over. First play from scrimmage is a dive to Bobby Frizzell, and Frizzell takes it to about the 40-yard line. Right now, the clock working in Swampscott's favor. Frizzell again, nothing doing, but it doesn't matter. As long as the clock keeps moving and the Big Blue contains possession of the football, it's going to be a pretty happy Thanksgiving meal for everybody in Swampscott. All right, Cohen under center, taking his time. Cohen drops back to pass under pressure. He eludes one tackler, and Cohen looks like he's going to get out of a jam here, making like Fran Tarkenton. I didn't know Cohen could scramble.
I didn't know either. He surprised all of us by that because I think he's some total running was 5 yards that year.
All right, Peter Cohen back to pass again under pressure. Great timing. Gets the pass off over the middle. It's just broken up. And so the Big Blue right now will have to punt the football away despite that great scramble by Peter Cohen. It came back because of a penalty. So Mickey DiPaolo into punt again, and Cohen gets this baby off, and great punt coverage, trying to pin Marblehead deep down in their own territory, and it looks like Mickey has done just that. What a great kick. Look at this. Dives right down around the 7-yard line. That's just what you want to have done with your punter.
It's not pretty, but it works.
All right, on first down, big defense by Swampscott. Great gang tackle there by Dean Anderson and Mark Stevenson. Swampscott's still in that 5-2. This Gopinski, you see him hiding behind the defensive end to the wide side of the field. Pass over the middle is incomplete. And so the Big Blue defense is getting the job done once again. Third down play here. Swampscott looking to contain. Pass over the middle. Great coverage there by Dean Anderson and Stephen DiPietro, and a big sack in the backfield. So Marblehead once again have to punt from their own end zone. Swampscott should get great field position here as we are moving late in the ball game in the fourth quarter.
Good blocking on this, even though we can't return it. But these kids are blocking and tackling. The line is doing a great job today for Swampscott High.
All right, in a quarterback now is number 7, Bobby Hopkins. And you know Hopkins. He loves to throw the football. He doesn't hesitate at all. Right away to Mike Maselbas.
Bobby is just a real good quarterback. He was a starting quarterback the next year. And... what a great year with him.
He's got Tony Blood wide open, and Tony Blood is in for the touchdown.
Puts that right, a perfect pass, caught him on the dead run.
Charlie Piccarella, number 40, is in at fullback. This is Stephen DiPietro on the quick pitch going for two, and DiPietro...
He throws his shoulder and gets in. Hard running back. He's a junior. he's going to have a good year next year.
All right, so Swampscott leads 30-6, and time is running down on the 1964 Thanksgiving Day. Swampscott wins it by a score of 30-6 to finish the season 5-2-2. Turkey pasted pretty good that day, right, Coach?
Well, I think it was good preparation on the part of all the coaches, and kids really rose the occasion because Marblehead was a slight favorite going into this game. But we just outplayed them and out-tackled and out-hit them, period.
So it was a game that Swampscott really turned on in the second half. What did you guys talk about at halftime? Only a 6-0 game, you wind up winning 30-6.
Well, we saw something there that we could break loose, running the ends and everything, and we gave the ball a little bit more to Billy Conigliaro, who had a great game. He had 151 yards and 17 carries. Peter Cohen was outstanding and throwing the ball, and it fellas like Tony Blood, Mike Maselbas, and the line came on to do a great job, and we turned it around. And after that first half, which was 6-0 at the half, we Billy broke open with two long runs with big blocks, and by some of the by Tommy Boyce and a couple of other linemen. Being a backfield coach, I knew all the backfield was a heck of a lot better than I knew the linemen.
When some loud bragger tries to put me down and says his school is great, I tell him right away, now what's the matter, buddy? Ain't you heard of my school? It's number one in the state. So be true to your school.
All right, so congratulations to the class of 1965, and have a great time at your reunion. For Coach Lynch, I'm Mike Lynch. Have a great time, everybody.
Yes, have a great time. There's a great bunch of players.